A pentagonal lamina of size 25 mm is resting on one of its edges on HP, with the corner opposite to that edge touching VP. The edge parallel to VP and the corner which touches VP is at a height of 15 mm above HP. Draw the projections of the lamina and determine the inclination of the lamina with HP and VP, and the distance at which the parallel edge lies from VP. So this is the given problem. So a 25 mm pentagonal lamina is resting on one of its edges on HP. So since he says it is resting on HP, so obviously we have to start the problem from HP. So since one of the edge has to rest on HP, so make that edge perpendicular to VP. So here we have made that perpendicular to VP. So edge is here and the corner is on this side. So since all the sides are resting on HP, so obviously it is parallel to HP. So I am getting the true shape here in 3D analysis. And when you look from the top view, I can see the true shape. And since this surface is parallel to HP, so obviously that surface has to be perpendicular to VP. So since it is perpendicular to VP, so I am getting a line here. If you look from this front view, ABC is near to the observer, so A dash, B dash, C dash is visible, and D and E is away from the observer, so D dash and D dash is invisible. So if you consider the 2D analysis, you can see here ABCDE is the pentagon, wherein this side which is resting on HP has to be perpendicular. Why? Because in the front view you are going to get a point. So this side, this is going to be a point, and this is a side because you have two points here. And also when you look from the top view, you can see you have a line here, so which is a side. And when you look from the front view, you can see there is a single point which is A dash, which is a corner. And when you look from the top view, A is the corner because you have only one point where the two edges are joined together to form a corner. So here, since all the sides is parallel to HP, so I am getting the true shape in HP. The edge parallel to VP and the corner which touches VP is at a height of 15 mm above HP. So this can be read as the corner is above HP by 15 mm, because this the corner which touches VP, which will come only in the third position, so is at a height of 15 mm above HP. So you can see the edge which is resting on HP and the corner opposite to this side is the corner A, which is the corner which is 15 mm above HP, and that you can see here that is 15 mm above HP. And this the shaded portion is the actual pentagonal lamina, the one which has been shown. When you look from the top view, this is the pentagon. And when you look from the front view, the surface is still perpendicular to VP, so obviously you get a line. You can see here. So how to represent this? So consider any point on C dash on XY line, which is C dash D dash, because he says side is resting on HP. And from here, from XY line, you draw a 15 mm parallel line at a distance of 15 mm from the XY line. Then measure the length from C dash to A dash. From this point, which is we have mentioned it as C dash D dash, from here you cut an arc by using the compass by considering the distance from C dash to A dash. Then join this line with a dark line. Then measure the length from C dash to B dash A dash, and from C dash you cut an arc on this to get the point B dash A dash. Then write the top view further. So draw a vertical projector from C dash D dash and draw a horizontal projector from D and C to get this point CD. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from B dash E dash and draw a horizontal projector from B and E to get the point BE. And similarly, draw a vertical projector from A dash and draw a horizontal projector from A to get this point A. Join A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, and E to A to get this pentagon. Next position, with corner opposite to that edge, touching VP, draw the projections of the lamina and determine the inclination of the lamina with HP and VP and the distance at which the parallel head lies from VP. With corner opposite to that edge touching VP, the corner opposite to that edge, that is CD, is touching VP. So A is touching VP. Capital A is touching VP. So you can see this is the actual surface which you are going to see in the 3D. So once the surface is inclined to HP, surface is inclined to HP, and also the surface is inclined to VP. So this surface will going to be perpendicular to the profile plane that we can see here, which will be perpendicular to the profile plane here. Now, the surface inclination I cannot see in the front view as well as in the top view, because you have a surface. In the front view, you have a surface of A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, A dash. And in the top view also, you can see A, B, C, D, E. So, this is also a surface. So, since both the planes you have a surface, it is not possible for us to see the surface inclination. So that surface inclination means it is surface is inclined for both HP and VP. So obviously that surface has to be perpendicular to the profile plane. So that is the reason why we are constructing the profile plane, wherein I can see the inclination of the lamina with HP and VP. So where I can see the inclination of the lamina with respect to HP, and I can see the inclination of the lamina with respect to VP. So how to reproduce this? Now, he says the corner is touching VP, so consider any point on the XY line and mark that point as A. So, you have to rotate clockwise. Then from A, you draw a vertical projector and measure the length from A to this point. From A, you cut this arc on this line, vertical line, to get this point. And draw a horizontal line here, because this line is perpendicular to this. Then measure the length from this point to C and from this point to D. Both will have equidistance. From this point, you cut it on this side to get C. And also and D. Similarly, you measure the length from this point to this, and from here you cut it here, and from here you cut it here to get this point. How? First you measure the length from here to this, and from here you mark that point, and then draw a horizontal line and measure the length from this point to this point, and from this you cut it, and similarly from this side you cut it on this to get this point. And here, since we need to rotate in clockwise direction, then A will come here. Instead of E, it should be B here, and this E will come on this side. Similarly, the C has to come on this side and D has to go here. This is because we are rotating clockwise. So once you project this A, you project this A dash will come here, then draw a vertical projector from B and E. Draw a horizontal projector from B dash and E dash to get this point. This is B dash and this is E dash. And draw a vertical projector from C and draw a vertical projector from D to get this point C dash and D dash. Then project, draw a 45 degree line, draw X1, Y1 line first, and draw a 45 degree line here. Then project the point A onto this, it will come to the origin. Then you project upwards, then draw a horizontal projector from A dash, you will going to get this point A double dash. And draw a horizontal projector from B dash and E dash, and draw a horizontal projector from B and E to 45 degree line. Then you project to this, where you are going to get this point, wherein B double dash and E double dash. Similarly, draw a horizontal projector from C and D, and draw a vertical projector from here, and the C dash D dash is on XY line, so you are going to get this point here. Then join A double dash to C double dash with a dark line.
and all the three points will going to lie on this inclined line. So here the naming is to be changed here, because this will be B dash and this will be E dash. So B double dash is visible and E double dash is invisible. And since this point is C and this point is D, so this point will be C double dash is visible and D double dash is invisible. Then you measure the inclination. So what is the inclination? The theta, the inclination with respect to HP is 23.05, and the inclination with respect to VP is 66.95. Because this has been done in the computer, so you are going to get up to the second decimal point accuracy. But when you are doing it manually, it should be 67 degrees 5 and this will be 23 degrees. The sum of these two should be always equal to 90 degrees. And this can be seen here also. So here 23.05, which is for the inclination with respect to HP, and this is 66.95. This is the inclination with respect to VP. So how do I know that my problem is right? So here the side is resting on HP, the corner opposite the side is touching VP, and the side which is resting on HP and the corner opposite which is touches VP is above HP by 15 mm. It is 15 mm, and this is a side of 25 mm. And also you have to measure the distance of the extreme side with respect to corner. So that is distance is 35.43, which has been shown here. So since the surface inclination is, since this is also a surface and this is also a surface, then obviously you will be able to see that surface perpendicular to the profile plane, which is RPP here. So this is the RPP wherein you get a line.